everybody, welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are doing a video that I've been wanting to do for quite some time now. We're doing, or not really wanting to do, but feeling like I should do for quite some time now. We're doing all my broken slash damaged, mostly Gemini jets, but just one 400 scale models. So yeah. So I thought it would be appropriate time to do this. You will be seeing this after that happened in my latest unboxing. I'm recording it like before it's even been uploaded, but so I can fix it with super good stuff. But yeah. Anyways, I did get this idea from Aviation 18, so credit to him. Great channel, you should check him out. Highly recommend it, but anyways, let's just get straight into this video. So I will point out, by the way, if they're my fault or not. So this first one here, we have the Hainan Airlines. So first up here, we have the Hainan Airlines. It was A330-300 in the High Manchester livery by Aeroclassics. This was my second M1-400 model. First one that I bought and saved up for myself. So this model, you can't see much wrong with it here, but oops, that's a little bit of stringy stuff. But if you flip it over, well, okay, so yeah, Aeroclassics, your wheels, they're really not great. You can see there's a wheel missing just there. There's a wheel missing just there too. Ignore that glue there. I tried to fix it myself. We ended up fixing some wheel, other wheels that fell off. There's a wheel falling off here, so there's three wheels falling off, and look, and these are super wobbly too. So they shouldn't be that wobbly. But they haven't fallen off yet. So yeah, that's the first broken slash damaged model. By the way, I'm putting out, I'm being very picky with these. Most of them aren't really broken, they just got something minor, but that one's a bit more than minor, so yeah. Okay, so I do use all of these in updates. So here we have a Cathay Pacific, my A350-900 by Phoenix models. This wasn't my fault, by the way, nor was that, that was from Aeroclassics. This was a painting like this, so yeah, it was given to me. I didn't pay for it, because it was given to me, of course, but yeah, it came with this broken nose landing gear. So yeah, there's not much really more to say about it. It's a very nice model, but that was not Phoenix's fault. It was a little bit, like, delicate, but still, it's not a toy, so yeah. I do hope to replace this with the A350-1000 at some point. Anyway. But here, this one is my fault completely. I purposely did it. I purposely changed this into just a blank DC-10 instead of the On the Air International DC-10. So there's not anything more to say about that. That was my own fault. Nothing to do with my jets. And then, now just here we have the Malaysia Airlines Boeing 737-800 in the special livery. I don't know how to pronounce it wrong, but I'm not going to say it. But yeah, it just says it there. But this model is by Gemini Jets, as I said, and it is, this one's not my fault. It came like this to me, and there's a wheel problem. I don't know if it's not focusing. So I've just focused it now. There's a little bit of dust underneath it because I haven't used it for a while. But there's the broken nose wheel. So yeah, that's what happened there. But so that was on Gemini Jets itself. Like, it never came with that wheel, it just came to me. There was no wheel in the box or anything, came like that. So that's not my fault, but it's not noticeable when it's in an airport update, not being used anymore. But yeah, moving on to this one, which is quite interesting because, like, this may be Gemini Jets' fault, or sorry, this may be the person's fault who had it. But previously to me, or it might be my fault, I actually don't know. So about a month ago, I noticed on this Ethiopian 2LR that look there, so there's no wheel there, and I checked back on my most recent video with this in it, and it did in fact have it didn't have that wheel. So I'm not sure if when I unboxed it originally, I think if you want to check it out, it was unboxing number 8 or 9. I think it was, 9 or 10 or something like that. But, yep. So, there's a playlist, by the way, if any of you want to check that out. my unboxings, but yeah. So I don't know whose fault that is. That could be mine, could be Gemini Jets, could be the previous owners, but yeah. Behind now, yeah, this one is my fault. So, yep. So this is the China Thunder 767-300 without wingless by Phoenix Models. I got this ages ago. It's again one of my first models. Seen it really anywhere? You probably didn't even know that I had it, unless you watch my old videos where I think I had it in the background once or twice. But yep. So the front here we have. This is the problem. The nose. Yes, like that other Phoenix one. Phoenix seems to have really delicate nose wheels. So this time that was my fault. And when we fixed that a little bit. But it's still like nose down. Yeah, that's a bit of a problem. But I think I... that. It's annoying because it's a very nice model, actually.
Yeah. Now moving on to
this one, which... this one, I don't know how it happened, but it didn't come like this, so it somehow happened when I was transporting it or moving it or something or putting it on the airport. But here we have the Hawaiian 767-300. I'm going to move another plane out of the way so I can put the camera here. But so this
model here is the problem under here, where as you can see there's no wheels just there. So that's a bit annoying, but that's the way it is. So that's all that's wrong with this model. So now we're going to move on to the next one, which I'm just going to switch the camera view for.
This just because I'm Australian and I like it.
But this is not my fault. This came like this.
Oh, Gemini Jets. So I haven't bothered to fix it because it actually slots in very nicely and without it coming out. But if you just wobble it a little bit, then it will come out. And after it's loosened up for a while, yeah. So that's a very annoying. Okay.
So just here we have the Air Mexico Boeing 737-800 by Gemini Jets. This was a birthday model, and in the process of building Cancun Airport, this model we were testing with it, and it got knocked off onto some concrete in outside. So it fell on the concrete, and the tail fell off. It's been glued in the wrong, like a bit too far back. This is very wobbly in lots of parts. You can see some stuff there, and the nose has a chip in it, but yep, so it's a little bit battered and there's a little chip back there too. But other than that, it's a nice model and I still use it in my updates and I love it still. So now moving on to the final model for this video, we have this one, which I'm not going to talk about. I'm not going to yell at Gemini Jets in this video. You can check out that unboxing if you haven't already, if you want to hear me getting angry at Gemini Jets. So this was Gemini Jets' fault completely. I did nothing wrong. I bought this model. It was a 2018 Alaska Airbus A320. And I opened it up and the wing fell off. Now, if you've seen the unboxing video, you would know that the engine came off. Because I think I mentioned in it that the engine was super, super wobbly. And then off camera when I was moving it off to the side, the engine just fell off. So yeah, that's very bad. I'm going to fix this once I finish recording this video, so yeah. But anyways, that is my collection of broken / damaged models. Most I only really consider this one broken. It's pretty much broken because of its terrible wheels and everything, but yeah. So, but the rest of them, I still use them. I do use the high end, but I do want to replace it. So, yeah. Anyways, thank you all for watching this video. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed. Thanks for all the support on my recent videos. My channel's doing amazing. I do truly, really appreciate it. I will be giving back to you guys at some point. That will be quite far in the future once we hit, like I said, 1,000 subs or something, if we ever do. Then I'll probably be doing a giveaway or something. So, yeah.
Anyways, thanks for watching this video. Like, subscribe if you enjoyed. Have a great day at home, and I'll see you in the next video.